Zane and Tony just then finding out what they were thinking before, and was kind of surprised that it was alcohol.
Come on, you weren't surprised.
Welcome to week 21. Education topic this week is visitors revisited, because we talked about it way back in weeks 4 and 5. But this week's education slot is just going back to the whole visitor thing. So our visitors, starting with who would you invite as a visitor? So to me, I would invite anybody that is like us in these rooms, that is involved in business in some way. We either own businesses or we're working within businesses. And what we're wanting to do is use the power of BNI to create and work within and enhance a network that helps us in our business life. So anybody that could benefit from being part of a business network is who you would invite. And Robert Kiyosaki said, the richest people in the world look for and build networks. Everyone else looks for work. So that's a compelling reason to have somebody else come and join this great network that we're part of. So why would you invite somebody? Well, it's a bit about your trust and credibility. What you're demonstrating to the rest of the group is that you trust the group to look after somebody that you've been prepared to invite into the group as a visitor. So it's saying you do trust this group and what it offers, and it enhances your credibility with the group because you're demonstrating that you are prepared to invite people along to join this networking family that we've got here. And one more reason why, Robert Kiyosaki. You know, it's all about if you want to become richer, one of the best ways to do it is via networking.
Sure.
So, the process involved, how you would invite somebody. There's the old way, which is quite simply, member invites a visitor, then emails the visitor host with the visitor details. The visitor host emails the meeting details to the visitor. And then the visitor host calls the visitor the day before the meeting, and the visitor host meets, greets, assists, and advises them with the process of what goes on in the room today. So that's how we've always done it traditionally. There's the desktop BNI Connect app, but there is now a new way, which is the app on the mobile phone. So who's seen the mobile phone app?
I haven't gone.
Oh man.
I suggest you all go to your app store and have a look. This is what it looks like. There's an example there. And you can see down the bottom here, there's a little button called invite. So just like any good app, you just press the invite button and follow your nose, and it will take you step by step through the process of inviting the visitor. And the nice thing is, it automates a whole bunch of the process, so you don't have to fill out as much detail. It makes the VP's job a bit easier because it sends all the information out to the all the people that need to know. So it just makes life a lot simpler and more automated in the way that we all do things in this the modern world via apps. And you can see Stephen Swartz here. He obviously does fairly well. In the last 12 months, he's got 24 referrals with over $1 million in revenue. Oh yeah. I assume he might sell cows or something, because that works out at about $45,000 a referral, so my only thought is he might be a new cow salesman or something. But he's also given out 63 referrals at $100,000 worth, so good example of how BNI works. So, education for the day, how to invite visitors, go have a look at the app, give it a go, maybe invite each other, just so you can see how it works. Thank you very much.
Very good.